Hello everyone, UK here. Sea of Thieves just dropped a brand new gameplay trailer for A Pirate's Life during Xbox Game Showcase Extended. We get a closer look at some of the new environments and a peek at what could be a brand new world event to the game. If you're new here to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button, and if you enjoy the video, smash the thumbs up. Now let's take a look at this brand new trailer for Sea of Thieves A Pirate's Life. Starting this trailer off, we now see Golden Sands Outpost, where in the previous trailer this was Sanctuary. This could now point towards more outposts being start locations for these new tall tales. What looks to be a player crew setting sail to one of the new portals, I feel now that this almost confirms that this is the entry point for the Sea of the Damned. Is there one of these at each outpost, or is there one single location on the current map that we have to sail through? Moving on to this incredible close-up of the Ferry of the Damned, helmed by the ferryman himself, we see souls burst through the grate of the ship. Also, ammo crate on the top deck! We get to play with a brand new tall tale compass while the weakest member of the group is still two steps behind looking at the picture book. Our crew is now in a cavern and we get our first ever glimpse at the Kraken underwater. This is probably one of my favorite clips in the trailer. Firstly, we have, well, I don't know, either Captain Barbosa's head or bloody hell, maybe even One-Eyed Willy, but I'll still probably get someone in the comments saying, "Oh my god, you're so wrong!" Secondly, if we look closer at this structure in the background, we see a tavern at this new location called The Last Stand. Then an aerial shot of this new island followed by possible underwater cavern locations. And of course, this lovely gold room. Brand new cosmetics, more than likely tall tale completion rewards. As if it was Pirate Emporium items, it would probably say, you know, Pirate Emporium. But a closer look at these, you'll see we'll have the Black Pearl ship set as a reward. Congratulations, Sea of Thieves, on giving us a brand new Ashen Dragon ship set. Then you'll see a Jack Sparrow costume and a brand new dog. A nice look at the three new ocean crawler enemy types, along with a strange new island location. Could this be part of the island we've seen at the beginning of the trailer, or could this be somewhere in the Sea of Thieves? A glimpse at a potential new Tall Tale boss? Let's just hope she doesn't pop up at the Fort of the Damned anytime soon. We get another look at the clock tower from the first trailer, only this time it's destroyed differently, with it collapsing rather than the clock tower being destroyed by a load of bubbles. Jack Sparrow breaks through a wall on what could be the Silver Blade. Next up is probably the most important thing we see, a brand new world event. My theory is that this event will be RNG based. The main tower in the back will rise up out of the water, followed by two massive mermaids. We must first attack and destroy both mermaid statues, to which at that point, Davy Jones will rise up with a Flying Dutchman and be the last boss. And the last part of this trailer shows two amazing things to this part of the update. The Silver Blade is now confirmed, also with another ammo crate on top deck. But seriously though, for the first time in Sea of Thieves, we actually get to see the Kraken. The fight on the Silver Blade appears to be some sort of boss battle. As the Silver Blade at this point is a hanging static ship, we also see what looks to be the Kraken performing an ink attack on the pirates. And that's it for this video. I don't know about you, but I'm extremely excited to play this brand new update June 22nd. I'll be covering everything next week, from guides, potential journal locations, the new world event, and the Pirate Emporium. So remember, don't forget to hit that thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one.